ఫ్రమ్ హ్యాపీనెస్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో లుక్ బ్యాక్ ఫర్ యూ.
సో
మీరు అలా మిమ్మల్ని అలా ముందుకు వెళ్ళడానికి అంటే లైక్ మీరు హౌ యూ యూస్ టు అప్డేట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్, హౌ యూస్ టు అప్డేట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్?
Yeah, Happy Days, in fact, was like my, I think, fourth movie. Uh-huh. So I did some movies before that.
Yes, correct.
There was quite a lot of struggle. A lot of people think Happy Days was my first movie.
Your journey has started in 2005, if I'm not wrong.
I've done a movie called Pote Pony. That was my first movie. Then 10th Class, then Notebook. So even before that, I started off composing, like, you know, Hindi songs and all, like, I used to just compose like rock genre and all that. Then slowly I got into Tollywood, as in, you know, I used to roam around the Film Nagar area and I used to meet everyone, you know, Shekhar Kamla sir and Dil Raju and other producers and all. So it took me a while to actually get inroads. And at that time, I think it was 2003, that's when I made some demos, you know, I recorded some 4 songs with lyrics. You know, Kulashekar, he wrote the lyrics for those demos, and Nitya Santoshni, she sang all those songs. And then I took that demo and I went to everyone, whoever I could, you know, whoever I knew, you know, I heard of. I went everywhere, gave them my demos, and there were some, you know, good suggestions, there were some bad ones. So it took me a while, you know, almost like 6 to 7 years of struggle just to get a break, actually. Luckily, I was from a well-off family, so, you know, it was not like, you know, I'm dying of hunger. And, you know, there's some great stories there, you know, people struggle so bad, you know. So, you know, I went through that struggle, and getting a break was a struggle. And I didn't know any Telugu, even a bit. I couldn't even understand Telugu. So that was another challenge. And then slowly I got my first movie, and then, you know, Happy Days came, and that was like a game changer for me. It totally, you know,
changed your
overnight, like, you know. That gave me big success, and, you know, the music, it was really nice, and the movie was really good too. And from then, there's been no looking back, and I've been blessed with some really good projects, like the next one was Kotha Bangaru Lokam. So in terms of updating myself, I think I don't focus too much on the way I compose, because that's a natural process. So I don't want to really, you know, pressure myself into, you know, what do the public want, or what's going on right now, which is what's hot, and you know, that sometimes takes away the naturalness of a composer, you know. So you're not following your heart, but you're following the things around you, and you know, you feel that you're updating yourself, but in a way you might not. So sometimes I get that feeling, but I go back to my, you know, no, this is what I want, I will only do this, you know. So it's been a long journey, and that's what I think is sustaining me, even though there's like huge competition. During Happy Days, there were very less composers.
Yes.
But now there's a composer in every, you know, nook and corner of the city. Okay. And there are young composers who are good, and they have, you know, they have great ideas. So it's always a tough place to be in the film industry, you know. And then you have to, apart from music, the movie has to do well too.
Yes.
So nowadays that's become such a huge criteria. If the music is great, if the movie doesn't do well, everything goes down, you know, the hits on YouTube goes down, and everything is treated as flop.
Okay. So ante basically appatlo bands, school lo competitions alanti emaina undava sir meeku?
Yeah, I used to participate a lot. I used to participate in singing competitions.
Okay.
And when I was probably in 7th or 8th standard, I started singing in All India Radio. One of my teacher, he used to come from Old City. So he had lots of contacts in All India Radio, and his guru, Vithal Rao, he used to, you know, do a lot of programs in All India Radio. So this guy, he got me in, and that was first time I actually recorded anything. So I went to All India Radio, I saw all these recording
equipment,
and it was like, wow, this is great. Even though it was outdated equipment, but it was like fascinating.
Yeah.
And that's when I actually started recording, and I recorded and I heard it back. So I felt, I could see what is it like, you know, recording and hearing your stuff back. And then we used to record there and come back, and they used to tell it's gonna air in 2 days.
Okay.
So all my family used to sit and turn on that radio and listen to that.
So okay,
my dad
yeah.
used to come and you didn't sing so well or you know whatever. So there was a lot of music in my home.
Okay.
And my dad also, you know, he was an industrialist.
Okay.
But he really loved music, and you know he was so passionate about music. He did like lots of shows here. Like he used to call all these artists from Bombay, you know, Sonu Nigam, Manade,
okay.
Kavita Krishnamurti, and Abhijit,
okay.
all those people of that era, you know, 90s.
Yeah, yeah.
He used to do programs here, you know, like he was passionate. He just wanted music around him. So that was another phase in my life, you know, where
okay.
I used to go to these programs. And I used to see the whole orchestra playing, and you know, my dad used to organize, so I was like free entry, and I used to go sit at the backstage.
Okay.
And then slowly I started singing in some of those
programs.
So there was a lot of music.
Sir, as you mentioned, you were inclined towards singing at that age.
Yeah.
So can you sing a song for us now? Any two lines of your
composition? I really hate singing. I mean,
now?
Maybe later I'll sing towards the end of the interview.
Okay. So, ee singing ilanti vanni ee shows ivanni jarigina tarvata
yeah.
A time lo meer composing vaipu like ledu I have to take composing like I have to start composing ani
when that was after school.
School.
Because once I finished my 10th standard
okay.
I didn't want to go to college. And I was like so much, I had done so much in music by then that I was like all these years I learnt it. Now what, you know, I don't want to go to college and just have all that wasted, you know. So I told my dad that, you know, I'm not interested in education. But he wanted me to be a engineer and, you know,
okay.
he wanted me to take care of his whole industry and all that. I was not interested, and that's when, you know, I was more pumped up and I was like, I've learned music and I have to do something, you know, on my own and compose songs. And I was, you know, really wanting to have a studio and compose because I had seen some studios at that time.
Okay.
So I was like, I need to compose. And that's when I went to college for a year and then I stopped it. And even my dad understood that, you know, it's let him just do what he wants.
Okay.
So that's when I started composing, and, you know, I started off composing in my home.
Okay.
And I recorded some stuff, and that's when I made this album. And
okay, at that time only you started doing this. Okay.
During my inter first year.
Okay. Meeku ala challenge chestunappudu like that was like really very peak time for you, and you have to prove yourself to your dad and make him understand that your interest is in some other field.
Yeah.
So aa time lo evana challenge kaani lekapothe you know to make them understand what you really want.
Yeah.
Did you
feel it was hurtful? It was actually, there was some really frustrating time for me because I knew I could do really I still today I believe, you know, I could have been a composer 5 years earlier too. I mean, before I did my first movie I could have easily done music for a movie 5 years before that.
Okay.
Because some of the time I wasted in college and I used to be with my dad in his industry too.
Okay.
So I feel that 5 to 6 years I completely wasted it. All that time I knew that I was wasting time and music was kind of just at a stop, you know.
Okay.
I wasn't doing anything in music.
Okay.
So just my equipment at home was just turned off and I wasn't really composing nothing. So I was actually, you know, convincing my dad that, you know, this is not where I have to be. Music is what I need to do.
Okay.
So those 5 years I feel I still lost it, but I was very young, so it's okay, you know. Whatever happens, happens for good.
Yeah.
And then when I was, you know, meeting people, there were kind of lots of, you know, comments which, you know, I didn't used to like, you know. Some people used to tell me on face, you know, no, you first learn Telugu.
Okay.
When you don't know the language, how will you compose for movies and all?
Correct.
So they used to be like, you won't know the lyrics, so how will you make a song where you don't know what it is saying? So I kind of, you know, used to get dejected sometimes, but I knew that I have to do it. So I just heard that and just let it go, and I just kept on, you know, trying.
Coming to today's you know, the music composers or something. Yeah. I just, meer ippudu cheptunte naaku adi gurtochindi. When they used to tell that, first you have to learn the language and then get into the films.
Yeah.
Now we see different composers from the other languages composing for Telugu films.
Yeah.
Now, what do you have to say about it?
Yeah, it's a totally different scenario nowadays.
Yes.
Happy Days was 2007.
Yes.
And when I was struggling, you know, meeting people, it was probably 2003 or 4.
So okay.
There was not much of social media back then. No reviews online.
Yes.
Nothing, you know. Just it was very simple and nice.
Yeah.
So nowadays, yeah, there's so many composers coming in from different, you know, cities and countries. It's good because, you know, I see myself as a perfect example. You know, I don't have a command on Telugu language.
True.
Definitely not when I did Happy Days and KBL, you know.
The starting phase of your career.
Yeah. So, I don't see, everyone knows that language is, you know, it's not really a barrier.
Hmm.
When it comes to music, especially language, absolutely not. You know, you can compose something in Brazil and, you know, people will like it.
Yeah.
Know? So, nowadays, yeah, it's been proven, you know. There's I've seen some composers in Bollywood, they're foreigners, you know, Westerners.
Correct.
But they're doing like so many ads and jingles and all that. So, languages, I think, nowadays it's not really a concern.
So, after Happy Days, you know, for the first film itself, I watched Ochin Tarvata. మీకు ఒక్కసారి అనిపించిందా మీరు అన్ని రోజులు పడిన యూనో యర్ ఛాలెంజెస్ విత్ యర్ డాడ్ యూనో టు మేక్ హిమ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ అండ్ దెన్ యువర్ స్ట్రగ్లింగ్ పీరియడ్ టు గెట్ ఆన్ బోర్డ్ ఫర్ ద ఫిల్మ్స్ హౌ డిడ్ దాట్ ఫీల్ ఎట్ దాట్ టైమ్ బై సీయింగ్ యువర్ అవార్డ్స్
యా వెల్ ఐ వాజ్ నెవర్ అ అవార్డ్ గాయ్ ఐ మీన్ ఐ వాజ్ హ్యాపీ అబౌట్ ద సక్సెస్ అండ్ యా ఐ వాజ్ థ్రిల్డ్ టు గెట్ ద ఫిల్మ్ఫేర్ అవార్డ్ But yeah, I was definitely really relieved because I had made some name for myself.
Yes.
And I knew that now I don't have to do anything else. I can survive by being a composer.
Yes.
So that was a, for me, it was a big relief as in, you know, like financially or, you know, as because you get out of college, you want to have a job, right?
Yes.
Apart from whatever your dad has or whatever your mom has or whatever business they have, you want to do something on your own.
Yes.
So I was finally relieved that, okay, I have done something good, you know, it's a big hit, everyone's enjoying the music, you know, and I was looking forward to being, I was looking forward to music being a profession for me. So that really relieved me and it was a great feeling, you know, Happy Days was one of the biggest hit, you know.
Yes.
I think after that, I have not seen a movie that be such a big hit as in, you know, from nothing.
Yes.
If you take other movies like their, you know, Bahubali and all that, it's another level.
Yeah.
But Happy Days was like a dream come true for everybody, you know.
Yeah.
That was like a fairy tale.
Yes.
You know? And I feel every composer needs one movie like that in his career.
Yeah.
Which is like, you know, comes from nowhere and goes like, you know.
Correct.
So that was my fairy tale movie.
Basically, songs are very important to film ki. Background score is also that important because they have it. It itself takes the movie to another level. It elevates completely.
Yeah.
So background score chestunappudu, do you have any, you know, scene ki ante emaina challenges la untaya the music background score ki particular ga compose chestunappudu?
Yeah, I mean, background score is definitely a whole different thing apart from songs. The way I understand a movie is it's all through my career, I have kind of understood it in a different way than the directors would, you know, think.
Could you just explain what it is, in like what way you understood?
There have been challenges, like when I did Happy Days, when I finished the whole score and they saw the score in the DTS theater and Shekhar sir, he called me in the middle of the night. This was probably a week before
release. Okay.
And he called me and he just called me to Ramanaidu and he said, he asked me, hey, whatever you did, do you feel it's good enough? And I was like, I feel it's great. And then he said, no, they are saying it's little light, you know, the music is not that heavy.
Okay.
There's not too many instruments.
Okay.
Which is, you know, people were used to, you know, bombarding the session with so many instruments on the scene, even if it's not required.
Yeah.
So there was a certain way of doing background score when I was doing Happy Days. But I kind of just followed my heart and I was like, if I just need one guitar, I'll just put one guitar. You know, I don't want to put anything extra. As long as it works for the scene, it should be good. So I went with that feeling, and after the whole score was done, they had kind of, you know, they saw it in the DTS theater and maybe they felt it was light.
Okay.
So I told Shekhar that, you know, it has the feel, it is good.
Yeah.
Now light or heavy, I don't know what that is, but it has the feel, and they had no time actually.
Okay.
So they went with everything.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I had to really, you know, every time, like when I did Sita Mama Kitlo, I did first half of the movie, the score.
Yeah.
And they didn't like it.
Okay.
And there was no time for the release. There was only like 15 or 20 days.
Okay.
So then they went to Mani Sharma.
Yes.
And I was okay, you know, like I made it with something. I felt that is what it should be.
Yeah.
If they don't like it, then it's fine.
Okay.
So every time I have to kind of impress them again and again and again. Like when I did Subramanyam for Sale, Harish Shankar had total confidence in me. You know, he was like, Mickey, you just do it. No problem.
Yeah.
And I told him initially, sir, if you're thinking of someone else to do the score, I'd rather just not do it. You can try it somewhere. He was like, no, Mickey, you just do it. And then when I did everything, there was absolutely no, like, you know, very little changes.
Mm-hmm.
He just came, he saw, and, you know, okayed everything.
Okay.
So it's just sometimes, you know, I have to again, you know, because I think in a different way when it comes to background. I don't go by the regular way of background score where there's simply usage of instruments which are not needed, you know.
Okay.
And it's, of course, you know, when you hear it in the studio, it feels like with speakers, you know, loud music, it sounds great, you know, everything you blasted, it's gonna sound great.
Correct.
But that's not how I do background score.
Hmm.
So sometimes I'm able to convince the directors.
Okay.
Sometimes they don't get convinced. So I think couple of movies, even Brahmotsam, the background score went to someone else.
Yes. And then see, all these films are like okokka film okokkala undi pardaka. Shatamanam Bhavati recent ga vachina film.
Yeah.
National award vachindi.
Yeah.
Adi actually typical Telugu nativity unde film.
Yeah.
Daniki meer ichina background score, daniki meer ichina songs are completely malli nativity ki daggaragane unnai.
Yeah.
So danikosam meer emanna research kani ante ela undevi songs alanti emanna chesara, just you went with prati
cinema? No, I think it comes naturally to me composing.
Okay.
Like for even like Sitamma Vakitlu was you know, native.
Yeah.
Kotta Bangara Lokam was also native.
Yeah.
Happy Days was very Western.
Yes.
So I think I get both of the worlds good, like Western and, you know, more native.
Mm-mm.
That comes naturally to me.
Mm.
And I think it's easy for me to create anything.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then coming to the singers.
Yeah.
Like ippardaka nen interview chesina vaallu kani lekapothe naaku telisina na friends kani evaruna kani.
Okay.
They tell that మిక్కీ గారి దగ్గర పాడడం అంత యునో హ్యాపీనెస్ అండ్ దెన్ కంఫర్టబుల్గా ఉంటుంది అని చెప్పి.
ఓకే.
అండ్ మీరు వాట్ ఈస్ దాట్ పర్టిక్యులర్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ గివ్స్, వై ఈస్ దాట్?
ఐ డోంట్ నో,
లైక్ ఏం చేస్తారు మీరు? లైక్ దే సెడ్ దాట్ యు నో వాట్ టు యునో ఎక్స్ట్రాక్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ దెమ్.
ఓకే.
యునో వాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ యూ నీడ్?
ఐ డోంట్ నో, ఐ జస్ట్ రికార్డ్, I just let them sing whatever they want to sing.
Okay.
Of course, I you know, we do retakes and all.
Uh-huh.
But I don't see myself as a, I'm a composer, you're a singer, you know, you have to sing this way, that way, and, you know, like those temperaments you have,
yeah,
you know,
correct,
with all the success you have and all that.
Yeah.
I never saw myself as that.
Hmm.
And it's just, I, you know, treat it as a song, and whatever they sing, I just keep recording, and then I have so many enough takes. Then I just work on the session and bring something out good.
Yeah. Like, what about the newcomers, new singers?
Yeah.
You know, you introduced few, you know, singers in your films.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have given them the chances in your film. So, and especially the Telugu singers here in your first movie. And then, you know, till Shatamanam Bhavati, you have encouraged so much of talent.
Mm-hmm.
So, how do you select them? On what basis do you select them?
I listen to their songs online.
Okay.
usually for me it gives me a better judgment if I sing, if I listen to someone who's already recorded something for another movie or something.
Okay.
And when I hear that, I can probably gauge that, you know, it'll be good for my songs and all.
Okay.
So I listen to a lot of stuff online.
Mm-hmm.
I keep listening to demos and all that.
Okay.
If I like some certain voice, then I firstly record a scratch with them, you know, just singing without lyrics, just a scratch.
Ah.
Okay. And then I go with the lyric, and so it's just a continuous process where you keep listening to other artists.
Okay.
And if it's good, you know, you record them.
Okay. And I also heard that whenever you compose, you get to, you'll ask the lyricist what exactly the meaning of...
Yeah, I used to do that a lot before.
Uh-huh.
Nowadays, I don't...
You started understanding the language.
I mean, lyrically, see, even today, I can understand my own songs, I can say up to 30% or maybe 30 to 40%.
So from 10%, you
yeah, because some literature words I cannot really understand. But if they use like certain words, I can, you know, understand, like vanilla and whatever, you know. So I don't want to really limit my thought process, or, you know, I don't want to spend time on understanding the lyrics actually.
Mm-hmm.
I just leave it to the director.
Okay.
So maybe that's why, you know, unconsciously I my melody matches well to the lyric, you know, because I'm not, you know, changing anything
in the lyrics.
And all. So the lyric writer is getting full freedom to use whatever words he wants, and the director foresees everything. As a composer, I just see that, you know, the sounding is good and the meter is good. So I don't really, lyric is not my department actually.
Yeah. And could you just tell me about these audio launches which are happening right now, currently? Audio launch is something meant for the music, for the songs, to perform, the singers, the music director.
Yeah.
These days we rarely get to see such kind of a scenario, you know, the singers coming in performing. More, you know, there is the event is happening, but with some other things around. So what do you have to say about it?
I don't know. I mean, finally, it's, you know, the whole system of how it works is, I don't know, it's probably have to do with TRP ratings, or I don't know, I mean, what people want to see.
Okay.
I don't know, maybe they think people might be bored listening to artists on stage.
Okay.
I don't know exactly, you know, I would love to have artists singing on the stage, but there are other, you know, challenges, as in the sound system, you know, when you when you want to do a live, it's really difficult because there's so many other factors, there's so much crowd, there's no time to set up your system that day in the afternoon and do a full sound check. So there's no time for anything. And sometimes when you perform on stage, the sound is not good or it's not balanced well. So it sounds bad on TV. So maybe they want to avoid that.
Okay.
So maybe they want to have stuff that looks and you can hear it good. Maybe that's one of the factors.
Okay.
And I don't know, maybe they feel they need to have something more than just singing.
Okay.
They want to have some, you know, acrobatics or this and that.
Okay.
So it's just a whole different system that's being followed. So I cannot really... You know, I'm happy with whatever we can get to do on the stage.
Okay.
As in, you know, the singers and all.
Do you feel that, you know, at least from now they should start doing this much, like get, especially for the audio launches, because they are, audio launch itself is for the music,
well,
right?
If you ask me, I would like audio launch to be in a, you know, a little quieter, where, you know, the artists are introduced.
Okay.
The actors are introduced, like how it happened when Happy Days and KBL was there. There were smaller venues and lesser number of people. Of course, you can't do that with big stars.
Yes.
But I'm talking about, you know, medium budget movies where, you know, the director can say stuff, you know, the singers can talk about it. The sound engineer can also be a part of the stage. The mixer person who mixes the song. And so there, it can be a fully, you know, a program which has all the technicians in it. Okay. But I don't think that's going to work. Because people want entertainment at the end of the day. I think Audio Launch is looked up as something entertaining nowadays.
Yeah.
So they think of various different ways, you know, to have something which can, you know, catch the attention of the viewer. So I don't know exactly. I'm not doing those programs, so I don't know.
That's a simple answer.
Because there's money going into it, I think. Yes. Someone's being paid and someone needs to make money out of it. So it's their own, you know, headache or whatever you call.
So, what according to you is an auto-tuner used for the songs?
Yeah. Auto-tune, you know, I'm sure everyone knows about it.
No, everyone knows about it. The usage of auto-tuner, what do you have to say about it? So, for some songs, it is like we are hearing a little bit of auto-tuner.
It's fine if it's used for a certain purpose. Like when I do my songs, I rarely use auto-tune.
Okay.
So when I record itself, I take a lot of takes.
Okay.
And then I, you know, when my track is finalized, all my takes are good without any off pitch.
Okay.
So it sounds good, and then I put auto-tune.
Okay.
Not to really change the sound, but it's just a technology which is good.
Okay.
I'm not against auto-tune. It's actually really good.
Yeah.
And when you just overuse it, like every song, if you start putting it, the singer's tone is lost.
Yeah.
What auto-tune does is if you pump it up really high, whoever is singing it, his voice is going to change.
Yes, yes.
So when I do my songs, I want the people to know that he or she has sung it and it's their voice rather than auto-tune voice. So I'm kind of minimalistic using auto-tune.
Okay.
But it's good. It's a good tool.
Yeah.
Sometimes I use it on my voice too.
Okay. So basically when you ask the singer to come and to record the song, basically you sing the track or?
Usually when I give a song to my directors, firstly it's my voice that goes to them.
Okay.
And then because there's a certain, you know, feel that I put into my voice, which is important for them because they need to get the right feel.
Yes.
And sometimes it with the chorus, sometimes it is with the final voice.
Okay.
So usually I record it myself.
Okay.
And I show it to them, and then when they okay, then we record the whole singers and everything.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, we are almost at the end of the interview. So I want you to, you know, okay, before that, tell me something. You have composed these many albums, right?
Yeah.
What is your favorite album till now? Any one? Just one.
Favorite album? I think it should be Kotha Bangara Lokam.
Okay.
Yeah.
Favorite song? Any till date?
Nenani Nemani.
Okay. That's your favorite number which you composed?
Because I never get bored of it. Whenever I listen to it, it's fresh. You know?
Okay. But let me tell you, not even one song that will make us get bored, which you compose.
There are quite a few.
No, not really.
You know. But these are my favorite movies, and because they were my favorite because the things that happened around them, you know, Dilraju.
Okay.
I met him for so many months and years. I met him before I got Kotha Bangara Lokam.
Okay.
Even before Happy Days, I used to. I used to actually trouble him a lot. I used to keep calling because I don't know why I felt like he was the person I wanted to work with. Of all the people I was trying to reach, something was there with when I first met him. I don't know. I felt like he's the man. You know, I should work with him. And after that, I kept calling him. You know, he used to call me sometimes. He used to be shooting around the city, and he was very encouraging. Actually, he never said I'm busy for 3 months, call me after that. No, never. You know, he was like, okay, I'm here, I'm shooting, come down and meet me. So I used to go, I used to meet him. I never thought I would do so many movies with him, and I never thought he's going to be one of the, you know, important
person
in my musical career.
Yeah.
So Kotha Bangara Lokam, when I got it, I was like, okay, finally I get to work with you. And that was special. That project was really special. And even the song Nenani Nivani, it's like such a beautiful song.
Fresh.
It takes
fresh,
you into another world. You know?
Yeah.
Because like I used to listen to old songs. they used to transport us into another world.
Yes.
So I'm happy I made some songs which at any time you listen to it, you will, you know, go into another world. Just close your eyes and you'll be like,
nice. You're there somewhere in the song, yeah, yeah. Traveling.
Yeah, you can feel the nature and, you know,
correct.
Like when I go to America, when I do long drives,
hmm.
my own songs, you know, for a while I was not listening to it.
Okay.
This time when I was in America, I was driving for like 20 hours.
Okay.
So I realized my songs were so, so good to hear because I was like, let me listen to my old songs, you know. So I started playing each album and okay. I was like, it just took me through the journey.
Huh.
And that's when I actually realized that the value of my composition.
Okay.
Actually, because it helped me, you know.
I yes.
Like, and I was like, wow, okay. So it's...
Okay.
For more videos, please subscribe to iDream.
And more videos, please subscribe to iDream Media.
Please do subscribe to iDream.
iDream అంటే నా కళల ఛానల్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకున్న నోరు తిరుగుతలేదు మీరైతే గంట గుర్తు కొట్టండి.